Now may I request Ramendra Kumar ji to make his points. Thank you.
Jai Jagannath. Subhagarani. Jai Jagannath. Aji Sokhade, this morning Professor Upendra Padhi did not welcome me. I was slightly puzzled, but then I realized in a galaxy of media personnel and academicians, a PR man is definitely not welcome. But I hope after I finish my deliberation, at least some of you would welcome me. Let me begin. Another important point is Professor Vinayak Chatterjee has kept one compounder between two doctors. Let me begin with a disclaimer. The views expressed are not that of my organization, Roorkela Steel Plant. 20% of my paper comprises the concerns of a hapless and a helpless public relations man. 20% the hurt sensibilities of a writer, and 60% the angst of an aam aadmi. I now bring you a sneak preview of News 2020, circa 2020, what it's going to be like in 2020. This is Exclusive TV beginning, bringing you the news. In the headlines, Alia ki akal, Alia Bhatt's new quiz show goes online today. Alia will question the audience on particle physics, ethical stripping, science of the soul, and the black hole. A young man is gang raped. A young woman is gang raped on a bullock cart in Haryana. The first such incident on planet Earth. Please note the hashtag, is the Indian man going back to his roots? Keep the tweets flowing. We'll have a panel of experts, including a psychiatrist, a psychopath, a feminist, and a representative of PETA. Along with that, we have some exclusive footage of the bullock cart in motion. Earlier, the question plaguing humanity was, why did Kattappa kill Bahubali? Now the question is, how did Indrani Mukherjee get hair dye in the jail? Planet Earth wants to know. Your channel has put 21 of its crack sharpshooters on this case to unearth this sinister scandal. Or answer this question, how did Indrani get die in the jail? The next edition of IPL will feature a team from Andamans called the Awesome Andaman Andas. We bring you an exclusive interview with the chief of the Jarwa tribe as to what IPL means to his land, his people and his culture. All this and much more at News at 9. In the rest of the news, Indian-born American scientist A.B. Raju wins the Nobel Prize for Physics. We bring you an interview with his mate, the postman and his PT teacher. Veteran Tamil freedom fighter R.R. Iyer dies in a village in Tamil Nadu. To know more about his story, you may tune into this channel after midnight. The Indian team wins 17 golds, 10 silver and 9 bronze medals in the Special Olympics, the highest ever. We will be bringing you a 2-minute report of this achievement immediately after the enthralling, exciting and electrifying 14-hour IPL auction. Let us now shift to the reality in the here and now. Last year I got a phone call from a reporter after a young executive had been crushed under a hot slab. The crane was carrying the slab, because of some mistake, the slab fell down and he was crushed to death. Again, I would have preferred saying it in Odia, but anyways. He telephoned and said, Mr. Kumar, can you tell me whether the head is still severe to the body or has it been separated? I said, how does it matter? He said, no, how many pieces are there of the body? I said, please, a young life has been lost. Let's not talk about these things and all. No, it's important to me. To make my news more impactful, I need answers to these questions. But if you're not willing, wanting to answer, at least send me a few photographs so that I can make my news damda. Every time there's an accident, I got a phone call from a particular, a scribe of a electronic channel, very popular electronic channel. And he says, Mr. Kumar, I just heard that there has been a gas explosion, 4 deaths and 5 people fighting for their lives in the ICU. Now I can almost visualize him visualizing the ticker line. 4 deaths, 5 people fighting, the next Bhopal. So then I tell him, bhai, this is not true. There has been some exposure to a gas leakage, and three people have been impacted, and they will be discharged after treatment. He heaves a sigh of relief, like a combination of Kamini Kaushal and Niruparai, seeing his daughter-in-law not listening to her or whatever. The ticker line disappears. Oh, what a disappointment. The ticker line has gone for a six. In Rourkela, for the last 4 months, and Odia Daily has been targeting the management of RSP, every day on the front page, there's been some news against RSP. Sometimes because there's a shortage of news, so the old news is repeated with a little bit of tweaking here and there. The circulation apparently has gone up by double, I mean it is doubled up. That is what their management wants. After all, integrity and ethics are values which are anachronistic and can go take a long walk in today's world of news. We could not extend a favor to another daily because of cost control measures. The gentleman threatened me with dire consequences and started detailing my biography on the newspaper, very popular daily, including casting aspersions on my ability, on my character, on my integrity, and even questioning the mota salary, the mota rakam I'm getting as salary, you know, why I should be getting so much. Welcome to the world of new age media, with new age values and uber cool attitude. I'll write or speak what I want, when I want, how I want, and the universe and its mother can be damned. Take the Arushi case. In the Arushi case, what happened? The entire family was stripped of its dignity. The whole nation sat and watched as the suffering family members were excoriated from their privacy and dignity during the most trying time of their lives. From labeling Arushi as a girl with no morals to accusing the father of raping his own daughter, the channels indulged in every possible act of savagery. On 22nd July 2008, a Supreme Court bench consisting of Justice Kabir and Justice Katju asked the media to be careful in its coverage of the case, abstain from making baseless allegations. It criticized the sensationalist media reports as lacking in sensitivity, taste, and decorum. And what language are they talking about? If media has sensitivity, taste, and decorum, then it's not media, na? Come on. These justice people also, na? They have gone off their rocker or something. Today, a newspaper or channel, as Madam has mentioned, has donned the avatar of a product and is marketed like a soap or a shampoo. As a result, the marketing department has become far more important than the editorial. Today, it is the marketing man who dominates or even sometimes dictates the editorial policy. He believes that no news is bad news is good news, and good news is no news at all. Bad news gets the product more TRPs or more circulation, which in turn translates to more sponsors and more money. And where the only mantra is mula, does ethics, truth, and credibility matter? And this is not my opinion. Let me share the opinion of one of the greatest icons of our times, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Why is the media in India so negative? Why are we so embarrassed to recognize our own strengths, our achievements? We are such a great nation. We have so many amazing success stories, but we refuse to acknowledge them. Why? I was in Tel Aviv once, and I was reading the Israeli newspaper, Dr. Kalam writes. It was a day after a lot of attacks and bombardments and deaths had taken place. The Hamas had struck, but the front page of the newspaper had the picture of a Jewish gentleman who in 5 years had transformed his desert land into an orchid farm and a granary. Saurav Kadia was the first Indian martyr to be butchered by Pakistan. His body was cut into small pieces. I was doing a project, I talked to his brother, and his brother told me that when the body was brought, his face was the size of a fist. Every possible torture was done. How many new media houses have highlighted that kind of torture? And just 2 days back, the same thing has happened. For the last 16, 17 odd years, Saurav and his father has been writing a petition to the government to declare these crimes as war crimes and to bring Pakistan to the International Court of Justice in Hague. But nothing has been done, and 2 days back, again you had, and again you had scores of panel discussions talking, making Pakistan a rogue state. Nothing has happened. Dhyan Chand, the wizard of Indian hockey, the guy who made the Hitler eat humble pie, died penniless in a hospital. He has not been denied the Bharat Ratna. He was not given the Bharat Ratna. How many media houses have taken up this call? Except for a few, I hardly any. And who gets the Bharat Ratna? Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar gets the Bharat Ratna, who is the proud ambassador of a luminous inverter which can prevent the zipper of the blouse from coming unstuck. He gets the Bharat Ratna and not Dhyan Chand. I can give the example of Dilip Tirki. How many of you know that Dilip Tirki and I think Mr. Anil Bhatt would know, and Sachin Tendulkar have the most coveted record of representing the country the most number of times, most test caps. Dilip Tirki nobody knows, and Sachin Tendulkar is the god of cricket. I had given an idea to a channel that why don't we have a reality show on the lines of Saregamapa or Indian Idol and all, where a team of experts go to the villages and does some kind of a competition or a contest among the kids in swimming and archery in particular, and then select the best of them and get them to a metro and have another competition, and the best of the best should be promoted, should be trained and promoted to represent India in the Olympics. This was not a fantasy. I had gone to Agra Fort, and there if you see 8 or 9 year olds, they jump from Agra Fort down on a small well from a height of 100 feet. If they can do it, can you imagine what kind of a DNA they would be having? What kind of DNA would be having by be had by the athletes, our private brothers, if they are encouraged to, you know, if they are given the right kind of training, right kind of facilities? I'm sure we'll have Usain Bolts and Mike Phelps by the dozen. But nobody bothered about them, and I didn't even get a thank you note from the child. But I again do not want to appear like nothing is being done and all that. Before I conclude, let me give you two main points. When I came to Odisha for the first time, all I knew about Odisha was, as the madam mentioned, Kalahandi and Kalahandi and the shenanigans of politicians, particularly one politician who was, had a fight with Pratish Dandi. I didn't know anything else. When I came here, I got introduced to Jagannath culture, and I realized Jagannath culture is not a faith, it's not a dogma, it's not a religion, it's a consciousness. In this possibly every faith dogma can find itself in. Jagannath consciousness completely mesmerized me, and I presented a paper in Denmark on Jagannath consciousness, and the consciousness got a standing ovation. But how many of us know about it? How many of people who are outside the state know about it? They know only about Odisha as wealth, power, poverty, bribery, naxals, etc. So, apart from Jagannath consciousness, we've got so many, many things which are absolutely so humongous in terms of variety, in terms of quality. In fact, I say if Kerala is God's own country, Odisha is God's own paradise. So, what can the media do? Odisha should be highlighted as a one-stop destination that has everything to offer. Fascinating fauna, beautiful beaches, majestic mountains, gorgeous greenery, a mythological mosaic, a cultural collage, a Shapur Shangri-La, everything. So why don't we pick up the cause and, project brand Odisha as an experience, as a reality, as a truth. There have been some initiatives by the media which, like Samvad's blood donation campaign and its campaign to, promote the use of mother tongue. Samaj paper takes Gobindu Jyoti to different places. It provides relief during natural calamities and scholarships. Gobindu Institute of Medical Science and Research set up by the paper is playing a key role in the health sector. Then we have NDTV Save the Tiger campaign, Times Now's Fight the Perverts and VVIP's Reason campaign, Times Now's Cancer Awareness campaign, CNIPN's Girl Child Save the Girl Child campaign, etc. etc. One quote. H.L. Mencken, the former editor of Baltimore Sun, said, "The function of the press is to comfort the afflicted and afflict the comfortable." They are definitely doing a great job by afflicting the comfortable. I ask the media friends to now start getting up to comfort the afflicted. Finally, my prayer to my friends from the media, with apologies to Gurudev Tagore: where the media doesn't run after Moola, where the media doesn't run after Moola, and objectivity is held high, where sales and TRPs are not sacred, where integrity, not power, is the beacon light, where values are still valued and individual freedom respected, into that heaven of credibility, my Father, let our media awake. Thank you.